message.
To the pastor. He said to the pastors, woe unto you that have scattered my sheep. But when you know you're doing what God had called you to do, this scripture does not intimidate you at all. It simply says that God is up to something and it's simply moving some people out of the way. That's all that text says. The day is at hand when God will reckon them for what they have done and what he has trusted them with. God's going to deal with them. But that's not what I want to deal with on today. Because one thing that I appreciate about the text is God won't leave his people without shepherds, but he will raise up remnant shepherds. Jeremiah 3:15 says, and I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you knowledge and understanding. I must be talking too fast because you look like you don't understand. Ephesians 4:11 talks about, and he gave some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints. So we understand that God has certain people who he's raising up that's just simply being raised up to perfect us, to bring us to feel maturity. So when he comes, we all are able to go back with him. That is our ultimate goal, is to catch the train, the first train that's going to glory. And so, God leaves us here with hope after what we encounter from negligent leaders. He leaves us here with hope. He says he will gather those up that did not throw in the towel through the hurt. Those that didn't go back in the world because of the hurt. And those who did not allow church hurt to corrupt their hearts. He says, I'm going to raise those people up. I'm going to deal with this since I feel the room shifting. Let me just deal with this right here. See, it's really not about the hurt that you experience. Okay? Hurt, listen to this. Hurt is something that two people may feel at the same time, even though there is an offender and a defender. Say that again, I'm going to say it slow. Hurt is something that two people may feel at the same time, even though there is an offender and there is a defender. So both parties have a legitimate case of church hurt. However, neither one will be acquitted in the court of God. What are you saying to me, Pastor Ty? Neither one can stand before God and say, see what she did? Bad lead and go tear somebody else's church. But if we would just simply do what the Bible tells us to do, the Bible tells us in Matthew 5:23, therefore if thou bring thy gift to the altar and thou rememberest that thy brother hath aught against thee, leave your gift at the altar, go thy way, and first be reconciled to thy brother. You feeling justified in your hurt? God is looking, saying, everything you give me, I don't want it till you get it right. Oh, come on, take this big grown pig this morning. Come on here, we need to kick out all the ugliness in the church and realize my issue is not about you, but my issue is about being right with God. I'm gonna work by myself today. See, so we've got to go back brothers and sisters. I'm getting this thing right here. It don't mean I gotta run behind you. It don't even mean I got to be your friend. It simply means I gotta make things right. Because my Bible tells me in Matthew, blessed is he who is not offended in me. So we've got to make sure that we are not letting some of this stuff that happened in the church get in our spirit and cause us to miss God. But I don't want to get stuck right there. Because there is so much more to being a remnant than just being a survivor.
If you've been provoked, stirred, or just ready for God's purpose to be fulfilled in your life by this broadcast, come and visit Pastor Ty Watts at Wednesdays at 7 p.m. or Sundays at 10:25 a.m. at 12999 FM 529 Houston, Texas, 77041. Or she can be reached at 713-983-0445. That's 713-983-0445. Or you can also find us on the World Wide Web at www.remnantfamilyworshipcenter.com. And remember, Remnant, there's a home tailor-made for you, and it's at the Remnant Family Worship Center. Come on home.